Reggae music was born in the poverty and filth of the slums of Kingston, Jamaica in the 1960s. And over the past decade, it's become the rallying cry of the not-so-beautiful Jamaicans, the street people, the dirt poor, the derelicts, the hustlers and the pushers. It's also about the Rastafarians, strange worshippers of Rastafari, their name for Haile Selassie, the former emperor of Ethiopia. Urged on by the reggae beat, the Rastas dream through a marijuana haze of a return to their ancestral Africa. Reggae and reggae bands like Bob Marley and the Wailers have become a musical rage throughout the world. But to many in the Caribbean, reggae is the sound of revolution. There are 75,000 Rasta men in Jamaica. They're easily recognised. They don't cut their hair and wear it in long pigtails called dreadlocks. They all say they're religious and worship the dead emperor of Abyssinia, Haile Selassie, as Jah, God. And through their marijuana haze, they dream of going back to Africa.
For what we're about to receive, we give thee thanks, O Jah, Rastafari.
The Almighty.
Fire, 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 fire.
Marijuana is illegal in Jamaica, but the Rastas say they smoke it because the Bible tells them to. The book of Revelation says to partake of the herb.
Don't criticize it.
This is one reason reggae music scares the hell out of a lot of people in Jamaica.
And I will advertise it. Some call it tampi. Some call it dweed. Some call it marijuana. Yeah. Some of them call it ganja. Never mind, got to leave.
This is another reason reggae is rebel music. Bob Marley himself.
Bob, how important is the ganja to a Rasta man?
Ganja is a bird. This is herb.
Herb. Does it matter to you that it's still against the law here in Jamaica?
Every law is illegal.
Every law is illegal?
Every government upon the face of this earth today is illegal. Not one of them is legal.
Since independence in 1962, Jamaica has been plagued by vicious urban crime. Only a few years back in the mid-70s, what seemed to be mindless killing was so widespread, police gave up keeping a record of the number of people being murdered. By 1974, street violence and shootings were so rampant that the Manley government felt obliged to introduce some very tough anti-gun laws. And any Jamaican found with a firearm in his possession wound up at this place, what became known as the Notorious Gun Court, and it's a pretty awesome-looking deterrent. And even today, some 5 years later, there are still about 120 men inside that place.
Hey, man, what are you doing?
Do you think any of the Rastas have been involved in the killings in Jamaica over the years, or that's somebody else?
Rasta is involved in progress, in making understanding, like preaching traditional culture to people. Rasta no killers. You have to do good before you can be a Rasta.
You have to do good.
If he's baddie, then you're bad. If he's goodie, then you're good.
What would I have to do to be a Rastafari?
Well, the first thing you have to be born again.
Born again?
Yeah.
Would I have to be black?
Do you have a choice? If you have a choice, you better be black if you have a choice. Well, if you don't have a choice, come as what God said he has, right?
This is where reggae was born in the 60s, to become the rallying cry of the dirt poor. Not the harmless, lilting calypso of Harry Belafonte, but a menacing new sound threatening to tear apart the island in the sun.
No chains around my feet, but I'm not free.
Mali and other reggae superstars, people like Jimmy Cliff, Burning Spear, and Peter Tosh, have taken the revolutionary music of the offbeat Rastafarian religious cult and turned it into the biggest change in Western pop music since the Beatles. The Rastas want to take 2 million poor Jamaicans back home to Africa. For a handful of Rastas riding on the wave of reggae popularity, it's not so much back to Africa, but back to the bank.
Bob, is the message of Rastafari that you should go back to Africa?
Yes, and that the earth must rule by Africa.
Forward.
One government. Forward, not back, forward.
Yeah, go forward to Africa,
yes.
Not back.
Mm-mm.
Do you think that will ever happen? Do you really believe that will happen?
Yeah.
Even if the ganja-smoking Mali, ripped out of his head most of the day, seems hard to take seriously, there are Jamaicans like journalist Colin Campbell who don't write him off.
In terms of the words which comes out of Bob Marley's music, in his lyrics, I think he's most definitely a leader. He is a leader in terms of the voice of the ghetto.
But a folk hero, nevertheless.
Most definitely, he is. And probably the greatest contemporary folk hero.
Studio One, as we welcome our friends from Australia, our brothers George, Vernon, Gordon, and Peter. Okay, from Channel 9, now at 10 to 11 o'clock, before we get to Tough Gang at 11, we're going to bring on the kids. International Year of the Child, the Melody Makers from Tough Gang, Children of Marley. And these children are playing in the streets. Eye-served and observed by those looking on. 10 to 11 o'clock.
Children playing in the streets. On broken bottles and rubbish heap. Another little baby got nothing to eat. Call, oh Lord, in the ghetto, bitter was sweet.
Percent of Jamaicans are black and 90% of Jamaicans are poor, and they're the same people. This is the only place these kids have got to play, on the street. They live in this area. It's called Trenchtown. It's in the western suburbs of Kingston, the capital. And somebody once quaintly called this area a human garbage tip. Well, being here and seeing how the people live, it's certainly easy to see why Trenchtown doesn't make it onto the travel brochure. Bob Marley was born in Trenchtown. He told us not to go there alone. Said we needed security. What we would call protection money. A bunch of Marley's friends wanted $1,000 to take us into the ghetto. Local police told us it was dangerous and wouldn't guarantee our safety. We took a chance and were lucky. We met these men, former Trenchtown gunmen, street fighters who wanted us to film the filth they live in. What about the kids? They get it pretty tough too.
The most important thing is the kids.
Because all they do is play on the streets.
Yeah. So just look at the kids, right? Most of these kids here don't have no home for themselves right now.
They don't have homes?
No. They live in a rented place right now.
Yeah. Yeah. Jamaican poverty is violent poverty. And the dirt poor in Trenchtown often have nothing to do but fight, usually among themselves.
You notice all the buildings here are burnt out and...
Yeah. What, there used to be buildings here?
Yeah. Caused to a fighting.
Yeah? What, bad fighting?
We have a fire burn for about a week, don't we?
People get killed?
Yeah, a lot of people get
killed. Yeah, people dead, too.
Yeah? How many people get killed when you're fighting?
Well, I'd say, I'd put it at estimate about 700 and something people die.
In about six years?
Yeah. In the politics.
What were they fighting for?
Well,
nobody knew what the fight was about.
I really don't know what it was?
No, we just...
It was politics.
Why did it stop?
Well, it was a peace.
A peace truce?
Yeah.
Yeah, the two sides call a peace truce, reason it out. And we had some music going on for about 3 months, and we get ourselves together.
The music's pretty important.
Yeah. In a feel like that, reggae music.
Reggae music's pretty important. Yeah. But you're saying that the reggae music helps you to come to a peace truce?
Yeah. Well, I tell you, roughly about 5-6 years, I never went down there.
And now?
Yeah, if I want. I wouldn't go down there anyway.
Not taking any chances.
No.
We're the survivors. Yes, the black survivors.
But today, reggae comes not out of the filth of Trench Town, but from here, Island House, Bob Marley's headquarters in Kingston's Dress Circle. These days, Marley and the Wailers are surviving nicely. From recording in tin shacks to this sophisticated studio. The Gunja heads have also become business heads. Some Jamaicans think stars like Marley have sold out, that the music of the slum people has merely become music to the ears of the world's white pop promoters. But Bob reckons BMW stands for Bob Marley and the Wailers.
Have you made a lot of money out of your music?
Money? I mean, how much is a lot of money to you?
Yeah, that's a good question. Have you made, say, millions of dollars?
No.
Are you a rich man?
When you mean rich, what do you mean?
Do you have a lot of possessions? A lot of money in the bank?
Position make you rich? I don't have that type of richness. My richness is life, forever.
Even though the temptation is to laugh at a stoned Jamaican musician who worships a dead Ethiopian dictator, Bob Marley's view of the plight of the black man is hard to knock.
The black survivors.